Today we are going to start with the fifth chapter of maths, that is fraction. Okay, so today we are going to start our new chapter, that is chapter number 5, fraction. This word is very close to you because since first standard, or say first standard, since first standard you have been learning this concept of fraction. Okay. In this class we are going to learn in more detail or next concepts in this chapter. Okay, so before starting the next chapter, let us first clear the concept of fraction once again. Okay, so what is mean by fraction? See here, I'll give you one example. See, suppose there is one chocolate. Assume that this is a chocolate, okay? And I want to distribute this chocolate among 8 students. I want to distribute the chocolate among 8 students. And the condition is everyone must get equal chocolate. Understood? I want to distribute the chocolate among 8 students and the condition is everyone should get equal. So what I will do? First, I will cut this chocolate into 8 equal parts. So let's do it. I'm going to cut this chocolate into 8 equal parts. Okay. So see here, 1, 2, 3, 4. Understood? So what I have done, this was one whole chocolate. It was one whole chocolate. Whole means complete. This. WHOLE whole. It was one whole chocolate, complete chocolate. Okay, and as I want to distribute this into among eight students equally. So I have cut this chocolate into 8 equal parts. Okay. Now what happened? Now there were 2 students present there. So this first part, which I am sharing here, I gave to one student, and this another part, I will share this, or this. This one part I gave to the second student. Okay? Okay, understood? This one part I gave to one of the student, and this one part I gave to another student. So, now can you tell me how much chocolate? How much chocolate, not how many parts. How much chocolates I have given to the students? Out of whole chocolate, how much chocolate I have given to the students? Can you tell me? You will say two. Two parts I have given. You have to tell how much chocolate I have given to the students. How much chocolate means which the chocolate which I have shared, the part of chocolate which I have shredded, that much chocolate I gave to the student. But how much? How to represent it? How to write it in the form of numbers? That is mean that we are going to learn under the fraction. Okay. So see here, how to write that. See, this was whole chocolate. Whole chocolate means I have divided it into 8 equal parts. Okay. 8 equal parts. I have divided into 8 equal parts, but total equal parts I will write. This is a bar. I have written 8 below the bar. Now 8 represent total equal parts. Okay. Now out of 8 equal parts, 2 parts I have given to the students. So that 2 parts which I have given, that is which I have shaded here, will be written above the bar. Okay. So if you see this 2 bar 8, how do you this 2? This bar is called division bar. Okay, this is called division bar. Okay, or there is another name also for this, vinculum. This is called vinculum also. But you keep it in mind, division bar. Okay, so 2 upon 8, this can be read as 2 in the numerator and 8 in the denominator. It can be read as, this can be read as 2 by 8, 2 by 8 or 2 upon 8 or 2 divided by 8 also or 2 8. 2 8. So I have given 2 8 the chocolate to the students. I have given 2 8 the chocolate. Now see, I'm not saying two parts, I'm saying 2 8 chocolate. So whenever we say 2 8 the chocolate, I have given, that means what? There were 8 equal parts of the chocolate, and out of 8 equal parts, 2 parts I have given to the student. This is the meaning of 2 8. Okay? If instead of 2, there would have 2 more students came again, so 2 more parts I have distributed. Now see, how much chocolate I have given to the students now. Now see, there are total 8 parts. 8 total parts are same, 8 only. But given parts or shaded parts are changed. There are now 4. So now how much chocolate I have given? I have given 4 8 chocolate to the student. I have given, means which I have shaded, that much parts I have given. That means out of 8 equal parts, 4 parts I have given to the students. That is 4 8 chocolate. 4 8 chocolate I have given to the student. Okay, this can be read as 4 8. 4 8. 4 8s. Okay. 4 upon 8 or 4 by 8 or 4 8. So generally we read this way, 4 8. Understood? This is called fraction. Numerical representation of this, it is called fraction, and if we write in the spelling, it is called fractional number. It is called fractional number. Okay. So whenever sometimes what this can be given, and you will told to write fraction for this, so you write in this way, 4 upon 8 in number. Suppose the number is given, that is fraction is given, and the question is write fractional number for this. So 4 upon 8, how to write? 4 8. This way, 4 8s. Okay. So now 4 parts are shaded, so 4 8 chocolate I have distributed. Then how much chocolate left? How much chocolate remain? Remain means the parts which are not shaded. Okay, which are unshaded. Parts which are unshaded. So total parts are same. Total parts you have to write below the bar. Okay. And how many parts are left? 4. Again, 4 parts are unshaded. So 4 8th chocolate I have distributed, and 4 8th chocolate is still remain. Left back. Okay. 4 8. Understood? Suppose 2 more students came there. So again, I have 2 parts I give to them. Now how much chocolate I have given? How much chocolate I have given now? Out of 8 equal parts, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Out of 8 equal parts, 6 parts I have given now. That is 6 8th chocolate is given. 6 8th chocolate is given. See. 6 8th chocolate is given. Okay, and how much chocolate is left? Out of 8 equal parts, how much chocolate is left means how much parts are unshaded? 1 and 2. So 2 8. 2 8 parts are unshaded. 2 8 parts are, or 2 8 chocolate is remain. Okay, means 2 parts are unshaded. 2 parts out of 8 are unshaded. So 2 8. 2 8 chocolate is left back. Understood? So this is the meaning of fraction. Fraction is nothing but, if you say 4 out of 8, 4 upon 8. 4 upon 8 means what? 4 are also parts, and 8 are also part. Okay? 8 means equal parts, and 4 means shaded parts. here. Okay, so fraction means nothing but parts of this 4 or 8 are the parts of this whole chocolate, right? So fraction is nothing but parts of whole. Fraction is nothing but parts of whole. Whole means this. WHOLE, whole, complete. Okay. So this is the concept of fraction. Here in this concept, now you saw I have drawn chocolate here, and I divided that chocolate into 8 equal parts. Okay, and out of it, suppose 2 are shredded. That means it can be represented as 8 equal parts out of 2 are shredded. 2 upon 8. Here the condition is all 8 parts must be equal. All 8 parts must be equal. If the parts are in this way, here, this way 8 parts are there, means they are not equal. Then this and this one part is given, this one part is shaded. This figure cannot be represented in the form of fraction. This cannot be represented in the form of fraction because parts are not equal. To represent in the form of fraction, the all parts must be equal. This is the condition to represent any figure in the form of fraction. Okay, so here parts are equal, all 8 parts are equal, and out of 8 equal parts, 2 parts are shaded. So it can be represented in this way, 2 upon 8. Fraction for shaded part is 2 upon 8 or 2/8. Okay. So now, whenever we write 2/8, this number below the bar, the number below the bar represent total parts. Represents total parts. If you observe here, this chocolate is divided into 8 equal parts. So total 8 parts are there. And these 2 represent the number above the bar. Can represent shaded or unshaded parts. Okay. So now here, these 2 represent shaded parts. Shaded parts. Okay. Instead of shaded part, there can be unshaded parts also. If there is this way, if the question is asked for unshaded part, write the fraction for the unshaded part, then total parts are same, 8 only. Total parts are 8, unshaded are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6. Okay? See, 6 and these 2, total 8. So here, this 6 and 6 upon 8 or 6, 8 represent the fraction of our unshaded part of this figure, of this chocolate. Okay? This is also a representation of fraction. Representation of unshaded parts of the chocolate. The question can be asked in both the ways. Write the fraction for shaded part or write the fraction for unshaded part. Okay. Same you have to do. Give here bar. Below the bar, write total parts. Count total parts. Write below the bar. And the bar which are shaded, that write up, or if you have to write fraction for unshaded, count the unshaded parts and write them above the bar. Okay, so this way we have to represent the fraction. So today what you have to do, you know, in the fifth chapter, see here, do you remember, you have to share 1/2 part of each of the adjoining figure. Means out of 2 equal parts, you have to share 1. Here in the second, out of 4 equal parts, you have to share 1. Okay. So whatever number is given above the bar, that much parts you have to share it. Total, this number below the bar, that means total parts. So out of total parts, the number which is given above, that much parts you have to share it. Okay. This is just the revision which you have learned in the last year. And then what you have to do, see, in latest practice 5.1, in this practice first 4 questions you have to solve. Here you have to write fraction for shaded part, you have to write fraction for unshaded part, here you have to write fraction for this given fraction, a fractional number, and here you have to write fractional number, means in the spelling for this fraction, okay? So this work you have to do today. If you have any doubt in this, you can ask me. Until that, thank you and have a nice day.